Hello guys, I'm Tania, and today I would like to share to you about the summary of what I learned in International Business Class at IGMI International Business School. I will use this mind map to explain. First, international business is any business activities between parties from two or more countries. It could be trading, which is export-import, foreign direct investment, joint ventures, sourcing, offshoring, and so on. International business happened as a sign of new economy following the globalization and also the revolution of industry. And why the company needs to go international? They could get more investing opportunities that they can invest in many projects across the world and get the higher marginal return. Second, they could find the best source of funding and get more financial opportunities to get lower marginal costs. Moving on, now let's talk about the risks of international business. There are cross-cultural risks, commercial risks, country risk, and financial risk that will be elaborated later. Speaking about country risk, it is highly related to political and legal system in a country. If a country has a more stable political state and fair and clear legal system, it would be more favorable for foreign investors. There are three kinds of political systems. The first one is totalitarianism or dictator system, second is socialism, and the third one is democracy. While for legal system, there are common law, civil law, religious law, and also mixed law. Related to the political and legal system, government intervention is important to maintain the business environment in the domestic, also to protect the local companies, also to ensure that the international business that happened in the country is profitable for them. The types of government intervention could be like tariffs and quota for trading, also subsidy, incentives, and other regulations. Next is about financial risk. Financial risk is related to the currency and exchange rate. Same concept with the price of goods, the currency and exchange rate is also related to the demand and the supply of the currency itself. There are three factors that affecting the demand and supply of the currency in the country. The first one is by the demand and the supply of the goods at this country, which is impacted by inflation rate, relative incomes, and government restriction on goods flow. Second is by the demand and supply of the securities, which is impacted by the interest rate and also the government restriction on capital flows. The third factor is by risk perception, which is related to the non-economic state in the country. And now we're gonna talk about the trade and investment. The first one, why do the nation trade? Basically, on their own, the country doesn't have enough resources or capability to produce what they need and what they want. The specific reason will be explained in this theory. There are mercantilism, absolute advantage, comparative advantage, factor proportion theory, international product life cycle theory, and also new trade theory. Next is about how can country enhance their competitive advantage? It's explained by the competitive advantage of a nation, or it could be analyzed by Michael Porter's Diamond Model, which has four components. And last is by nation's industry policy. Next is theory related to the multinational company. There are two theories. The first one is the internationalization process of the firms, and the second one is born global and international entrepreneurs. And how the MNC can gain and sustain their competitive advantage can be explained by FDI-based explanation, which is by monopolistic advantage theory, internalization theory, and also Dunning-Kruger politik paradigm. While the non-FDI-based explanation would be international collaborative venture and network and relational assets. There are a thing related to the investment and is becoming a hot issue in Indonesia right now because Indonesia just established the Sovereign Wealth Fund, or in Indonesia called Indonesia Investment Authority. SWF is a state-owned investment fund that managed by the government related to the source of fund and the allocation of the funds to provide benefits for the national economy and also the citizens. Indonesia established their own SWF because Indonesia needs new source of fundings, which is not a debt since the debt to GDP ratio of Indonesia is already high. So the purpose of the SWF in Indonesia is to attract the foreign investors to invest in Indonesia and also to manage the investment into the critical project such as infrastructure. There are two ways to invest in SWF Indonesia. The first one is by direct investment. The second one is through special purpose company with the asset securitization process. Next, let's talk about the MNC sustainability. The MNC's operation in several countries bring some impact to the countries, which can be positive or negative. But as we can see, there is a lot more negative impacts, such as externalities that impacting the environment and social. So that's why a new standard or concept to operate the MNC is needed. That's why the ESG concept or environmental, social, and good governance concept is now being applied in several MNCs. If the company applied the ESG concept, it will lead them to create higher value creation for their companies, such as the top line growth, cost reduction, regulatory and legal interventions, also productivity uplift, and investment and assets optimization. And now let's talk about the international business strategies. There are four strategies. The first one is home replication strategies. This strategy focuses on the domestic customers' needs and wants, and merely export their products to generate more profit, so replicate their home market success. Second is multi-domestic strategy. This strategy creates the subsidiaries to meet the needs and the requirements of the local markets. So each subsidiary is operating autonomously and are independent from the headquarters. Next is the global strategy, which is the opposite of the multi-domestic strategy, which all the managements, marketings, and products are standardized and centrally controlled by the headquarters. And the last one is transactional strategy, which is the combination of the multi-domestic strategy and also the global strategy. They basically have the general strategy, but the branches is adapting with the local markets regarding the marketing and the products. And the last is about the ethics in international business. Ethics is moral principles or values that govern the people, firms, and government behavior regarding the rights and the wrong. The most common unethical things done in business are corruptions, bribery, piracy, and counterfeit. So, in conclusion, international business taught me that all the countries are interdependent with each other, but also competitive in the same time. Countries need to make profit from international business, but another important thing is to make a sustainable and also the good and business environment in the world, so every country can reach their prosperity. Also considering the impact of the environmental and social caused by the business activities. I think that's all from me. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.